Jasmine. Jasmine tagged along with Dana, like starch on rice. He, everywhere he went, she went. He walked this way, she was over there. He sat on the stage. She sat on the stage. She sat at the bottom part. We went up at the top part. We sat on chairs. So it was myself, the other ladies I was with in Dallas. We all sat up on the stage. The gym smelled so bad to me, y'all. I don't like stinky smell. It was like sweaty, a bunch of men and stuff like that. To me, it was like, okay, why am I here? I'm ready to go. But they wanted to sit there and watch the gym. Anything about? So we laughed because he mentioned something about the gym. And so she was asking me what was the gym address. So I said, well, why don't you get it from him? He tell you buy something sexy, but you didn't have a room. Wouldn't you use that $100 to get yourself a room instead of buying something sexy? So then, you know, she's like, well, I kind of figured she was lying, really. I really thought she was lying because, to me, somebody's sending you $100 and you would rather buy something sexy instead of getting a room for yourself, or a shelter. You understand what I'm saying? So I just blew it off. I didn't believe her. About, I would say, 12 o'clock that night, she calls me again. And she says to me that she had just talked to Rob, and he said he was going to the gym. She says, I think he wants me to go to the gym because he mentioned something about the gym. And so she was asking me what was the gym address. So I said, well, why don't you get it from him? She says, well, he didn't say that he wanted me, but you know, he's insinuating that he wants me to come to the gym. So then I said, well, why don't you ask Dana? He knows where the gym is. So she's like, well, I don't want to tell Dana because I don't want Dana in my business because he acts like he's my father. He's always in my business. So I said to her, I said, well, you need to probably find somebody else, right? So she hung up with me. She called me back again. She begged me. She begged me to give her the gym address because, you know, she really believes. And then she tells me that that the young lady, Cash, was going to pay for Uber for her to go to the gym. I said, well, don't you ask Cash for the gym address? She told me no. She didn't want her, to tell her that she didn't know or something like that. I didn't know. So, okay, I felt bad. And I said, okay, I'll give you the gym address. And you better not tell nobody I gave it to you. That's what I said to her.
Kissing me and stuff, and just guess the oral sex came in.
I know Rob, our last conversation that I had with him in Chicago, you know, he inspired me and told me, Bear, just do what you want to do, what makes you happy. He told me to continue to pursue my dreams, pursue whatever I want to pursue, and that's really all that I would be able to do.
So don't blame me when the shooting don't stop, when kids are not obeying their parents, or when kids are listening to rap music or R&B music or sexual music that I put out or whatever. Blame the parents.
It's not about what the world thought it was about. It was about me getting relationships with my daughter.
Don't paint no picture like I have not talked to you guys in over a year because I would call you guys 4 or 5 months at a time. So to believe something like that, so extreme, so bizarre, so outrageous, I just couldn't even fathom my parents believing something as bizarre as that.
One of the things that's going to be set by this is precedent.
And when I drop the videos, the pictures, the paperwork, for him to get on live to say that Azrael is not writing R. Kelly, really? Really? Now, I gave him R. Kelly's jail records. Ask him how he got R. Kelly's jail Jezreel and R. Kelly. So you mean to tell me I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about?
I'd like to thank everyone supporting the channel, and just to invite you to go and check out my site if you haven't already, pdpastries.com. We all have a dream, and as you can see, I intend to use my pastries to fund my own company.
Cookie, cookie, I'm a cookie monster. Break your back, crack it open like a lobster.